here.
Nonsense! We're a family!
Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes, but he says the same thing of humans, doesn't he, Snookums? And we both know that's not true, don't we?
Why did he banish you?
The ocean wasn't big enough for the both of us. And now he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling. We're so very much alike, you and I. Gals with ambition? Nothing scares the male more, does it? Now tell dear old auntie everything.
Well, I'm in love with someone. A human.
Yes, this prince fella. He's quite a catch. The answer's simple. You've got to become human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help you? My dear sweet child, it's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been asked to. They weren't kidding when they called me fellow witch. But you'll find it nowadays, I've mended all my ways. Repented, saved a life to make a switch. True? Yes. And I fortunately know a little man. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And now they make this of that. I use it on behalf of a miserable, lonely, and depressed pathetic. Longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl. Do I have them? Yes, indeed! Those poor and unfortunate souls. So sad, but true. They come flocking to my country crying, "Smell, Ezra, please! Do I help them?" Yes, I do! Now it's happened once or twice, so I couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had a race across the pond. Yes, I've had the odd complaint. But on the whole, I've been deceived to those poor unfortunate souls. Now here's my best offer, babykins. I know a spell that will turn you into a human for 3 days. But it's not a procedural clause, sort of a squid pro quo. Before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Nothing drastic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look. Small print. Your soul will be mine forever, and you're doomed to spend eternity in my watery hell so glare. Oh, yes. Don't you just love them? Of course, there's just one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have anything.
It won't cost much. Only your voice.
My voice?
Your grandpappy Poseidon gave his magic trident to your father. But this was his gift pour moi.
Magic shell.
You've heard about it?
Father says you could die without it.
Die? Oh, please. It's a bauble, a vessel for your voice, that's all. Don't worry, darling. You're the darling of the brother. Even your belt. They'll all be safe and sound in here.
But if I give away my voice, how can I ever?
You'll have your looks, your pretty face, and don't underestimate the power of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yes, and then they march no further, ladies, not to say a word. After all, do you think it's idle prattle for? Come on! Yes, not at all impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. And they don't deserve one. Not the lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets that man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. In you. It's important to be thinner that one wants to get the girl. And the thing that is indeed. Those poor unfortunate souls. So sad, but true. If you want to cross the bridge, my dear, you go. Take a gulp and take a breath. Go ahead and sign the scroll. Now I got a boy. The force is all wrong. You poor, unfortunate.
let me decipher it for myself. I got it. I got it. Your hairstyle. You've been using a dingle hopper.
She got legs, you idiot. She traded her voice to the sea witch and got legs.
Oh, no, not your beautiful pipes.
You see? Not a sound.
Oh, it hurts me to say it, kid, but that was a lousy swap.
What would her father say? I tell you what her father would say. He'd say, I'm going to kill me some crap. That's what he'd say.
She's got just 3 days.
3 days to do what?
To make the prince fall in love with her.
And to prove if he gets to, well, I mean, he's got to kiss her.
The prince? Well, if you want to snare the prince, you got to learn a graceful way of perambulating.
She'll do no such thing.
Oh, sure she will. Come on now. Upsy-daisy. You give it up so quick? That's not like you. You got to show a little gumption. Can-do kind of altitude. Take it from a girl who knows. Now look at me. You see this face? In terms of beauty, I'm a basket case. As for style and sound of fair, well, I guess there ain't a whole lot there. Though perhaps it makes no sense, I struck myself with lots of confidence. And though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I got. Positivity. But positivity, it gives me the zam and the zap and the yah, blah, blah, blah. That's why I walk with a wiggle in my wallet. Once you know that boy, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positivity work for you.
Positivity? Why, there's no such word.
But there is in the dictionary, right between popsicle and prehysterical. Believe you me, I've seen it with miracles.
The tip is
just
that, and it's something that you believe.
Turn the zinc, and it's all kinds of so-so-see. There ain't nothing to be. You see, it's really your prerogative.
You simply can't deny it.
Well, there's you just sitting there, smack down flat on the chair. That's the way you want to be. Well, you might as well be strawberry. So stand right up and dust your seat. Fuck real tall, but it up to me. It's your option to make mistakes. You got what it takes.
Are you hurt? You need help?
I'm a little dizzy. I got just the remedy. A hot meal and a warm bath. Come with me. You'll be fine. The castle is far.
Valeria! That's what I call real living!
I'm just gonna get me in some real hot water!
What a crap! Now you know that, boy!
Thank you.
Shall we?
And now for something truly exquisite!